I show you a picture of my first car, a Cortina GT English Ford, 1968. Those people weren't in it when I bought it. And the fact that they seem to be smiling in this picture indicates that they haven't been any real distance in the car. But, you know, you love your first car. You love it so. And I did. And it also represents to me that year, 1968, which was the most incredible year in my life, probably. I mean, it's not over yet, but, you know, it was pretty amazing. I was a huge Beatles fan. I went to London just to travel because I didn't know what else to do. I was a kid, 19, I guess. I made a demo tape at the urging of some friends I met over there. They shopped it around. Eventually, Peter Asher heard it, played it for Paul McCartney and George Harrison, and they signed me, the first act to be signed to Apple Records. It was as if somebody had opened a door. It was amazing. It was the mother of all big breaks. And it was as if somebody had opened a door and the rest of my life was on the other side of it. And I think that happens often, but in a negative way. Usually, someone opens a door and there's hell on the other side. Anyway, getting a little punchy here. The year did end, it had to end, and I sent the car home on a boat, and I flew home, and there was a tearful reunion on the docks in Elizabeth, New Jersey, and I hopped in my Cortina and started driving down the coast to North Carolina, because I hadn't seen my family in better than a year, and I during that year, my brother Alex and his wife Brent had a baby, first child born to our generation in my family, and in a moment of lapsed judgment, they named the child after me, little baby James. And so I had to go down and see this little varmint. Go down and see little James. And yeah, he's cute. You know, if you like children. But anyway, as I was driving down the coast, I was thinking to myself, well, what would be a good song to sing for a little ornery varmint like little James? And it had to be a cowboy lullaby, go to sleep, you little buckaroo, or lights out in the bunkhouse, or, you know, something like that. Something by Roy Rogers or Gene Autry. That's how this next song got written. Yeah. There's a young cowboy lives on the range. His horse and his cattle, they're his only companion. He works in the saddle and he sleeps in the canyons, just waiting for summer, his pastures to change. Yes, and as the moon rises, he sits by his fire, just thinking about women and glasses of beer. Closing his eyes as the doggies retire, he sings out a song which is soft but it's clear, just as if maybe someone could hear. He says goodnight, all you moonlight ladies, rock all by sweet baby James. Deep greens and blues for the colors I choose, won't you let me go down to my dreams? Oh, and rock all by sweet baby James. Now the first of December, it was covered with snow.
Yes, and so was the turnpike from Stockbridge to Boston. Oh, the Berkshires seemed dreamlike on account of that frosting, with 10 miles behind me and 10,000 more to go. There's a song that they sing when they take to the highway, a song that they sing when they take to the sea, a song that they sing of their home in the sky. Maybe you can believe it if it helps you to sleep. Just that singing seemed to work fine for me. So good night, all you moonlight ladies. Rock by my sweet baby Jane. Deep greens and blues for the colors I choose. Won't you let me go down to my dreams? Oh, rock by my sweet baby. Yeah.